Welcome students, welcome to the new session of the programming language. Today we shall be discussing about the control statements. So what are control statements? Control statements are certain statements which directs a flow of a program in order to execute some additional codes. So if certain things, certain statements are getting repeated and we have to write again and again, what is the use of the programming language? So these statements will start a loop. It will ask certain conditions, whether it is true or false. And then accordingly to the condition, it will execute the statements. So these control statements will execute some additional codes and it will direct a flow of the program in which order it should move, where it should go, which block it should skip. So these are all coming under the control statements. So control statements are of various types. So the types are if statement, if else statement, for loop statement, while loop statement, do while statement, and switch statement. So let us see one by one how these control statements work. So the first control statement is the if statement. When you read the if statement, from reading the if statement itself, you understand the meaning if. If means agar. Agar aisa hota, to kya hota, to ye hota. So if statement is a conditional statement where it will be asking you whether the statement is true or false. So according to the true statement or false statement, it would execute. So the if statement will execute only when the statement is true. So if statement will execute that statement block for which the condition is true. And if the condition is false, it will not execute, it will skip the statement block and go to the end of the statement. So the syntax of the if statement is, if the condition is written within the bracket, here you can see the bracket, then you have the curly brackets, and in the curly brackets, whatever the condition is true, whatever statement you want to get it executed, that statement is written within the curly brackets. Similarly, we have the if-else statements. So in if-else statement, both the statements would be executed for the true condition as well as for the false condition. But in the if statement, only the true condition will be executed, and on the false, it will exit out of the program. So when the condition is true, it will execute first statement block. And if the condition is false, it will execute second statement block. So you can see here, the syntax is if the condition is written within the bracket, then the curly bracket starts for the true statement. So statement one, whatever you are writing in the first, curly bracket, that statement would be executed. And if the condition is false, it would simply go to the else. It will move to the else statement blocks, that is the statement two. And these statements are also written within the curly brackets. And for the else, we don't have to mention the condition. If there is another possibility also, then we use else if also. So this is how the if and if else statement is working. Now let's see some of the programs also. So now let us see a program where we have using the if else statement. So in this, we want the number to be printed, that whether the number is even or odd. So we have designed a program which checks whether the number is even or odd. So for checking the number which is even or odd, we have to use the operator percentage. So when a number is divided by 2 and we use the percentage operator, it checks whether the remainder is coming out to be 0 or not. If the remainder is 0, then the number will be automatically equal to be an even number. And if the remainder is not 0, then it would be a odd number. So we have designed this program to check whether the number is even or odd. So here I have used both the input libraries and the output library, cin, cout, and also use the printf, that is the standard library So because we are using both type of input output statements, so we have mentioned both the header files stdio.h and iostream. And since we are using C in C out, you have to mention that using namespace standard also. Then we want that the compiler or the program will ask us to number to be entered. So we are entering C out, enter the number. Then it is C in A, we will have to enter the data. Then if A percent 2 equal to 0, if we want to equate it to 0, we have to put two equal signs. It will divide the number by 2 and check for the remainder value. So if the remainder value is 0, so the condition is written within the bracket. And if the value is true, it is equal to 0, it will execute the first statement, that is A is even. And then it will get out of the program. If the condition is false, then it will go to the else and it will write print the number is odd. So for else we have two curly brackets, for if statement we have curly bracket starting and ending, and for the main the curly bracket was starting, so again a bracket is closing for the main program. So you have to take care of the bracket, whichever bracket is open you have to close it also, otherwise an error will be shown. So let us compile and run the program. You can use the F11 also. So it is asking us the enter the number. We have written in the output, enter the number. So let us execute the number as 9. You all know that 9 is an odd number. So it will check the condition. It will divide 9 by 2 and check the remainder. The remainder will be 1 and automatically it will go to the else statement. So it will execute the else statement. So we enter it. I enter it. So what you get the number is odd. So the program is working very well. We can check that the if else statement is working. Let us execute it for another number. Let the number be a positive integer. Let it be 10. So I enter. So it has checked the condition. The condition is true. So when the condition is true, the first statement block, that is A is even, is printed. So I hope that you have understood the program. Now let's move to another if else program. So in this if else program, what I have done that I have not asked the compiler to enter the number. Here I have inserted the number in the program itself. I have declared int A equal to 0. You can see here it is int A equal to 0. And you know that 0 is an even number. So when it will execute, it will print automatically in the output that the number is even. So we compile and run it. So you can see here A is even. So let us change the number again. So I am changing the number to be 7. Now I save the program, compile and run it. So what is the answer? Now the answer is coming as number is odd. So what was the difference between the two programs? Here in the first program, the compiler was asking you to change the number at the output. When you compiled it, it was asking you to enter the number. But in this program, what is happening that you have entered the program, entered the value in the program itself. So every time you have to change the value in the program itself. So this is not a good thing that you change the input value in the program. Always it is desirable that you change the input values in the output stream. So this is better method to execute any program. Now if we design another program where it is telling you a program which is telling you that whether the number is positive or negative. So this is a program which is telling you whether the number is positive, negative, or zero. So we have to check the condition whether a is greater than 0, it is a is less than 0, or if both the conditions are not true, then it will write that a is 0. So again, we have printf, enter the number, then scanf. If you are using the scanf formatted input output, for scanf, since it is an integer value, so we have to write %d in the quotation mark, where %d is the control string and a is the variable. If a greater than 0, so the condition is a greater than 0, it has to be mentioned in the brackets, simple bracket. Then if it is true, the statement is c out is a is positive. Else if, now this is another statement where it will check that the number is less than 0. So again, if there is a condition, it has to be mentioned in the bracket, simple brackets. And if this statement is true, if a is less than 0 condition is true, then it will print that a is negative. If both these statements, either if condition and else if condition, both the statements are false, then it will go to the else statement and it would write printf a is 0. So whenever you see for the else statement, you don't have to mention any condition. Else means that it is a false statement, the conditions which are not true will be going to the else statement and it will write that whatever is written in the else block. So let us now execute the program. So again, here we had used the formatted input output. So it has asking us to write the integer a value. So I put the 7 number, I enter it. So since a is greater than 0, it has printed in the output that a is positive. Let's compile it again and see for a negative value, I put a -9. So when I put -9, so it is writing here for the else if condition, it is checking for the else if condition. So it is writing a is negative. Now, if I execute it for the 0 value, when I put a 0 value, you can see that it is writing a 0 because it has checked the condition for positive a greater than 0, a less than 0. Both the conditions were not true. So it has moved to the else block and it has write as a is 0. So you can see that we have successful in working with the if else statements. Let us move to another program where you shall be using the if else application. In this if else application, what happens that now you want your program to be designed such that it will be executed for the positive number also, and also it would be telling about whether the program, whether the number is even or odd. So I have designed this program. So here it will enter the number, it will ask you to enter the number. So it will check the condition that a is greater than 0 and equal to 0 also. So if it is greater than 0 or equal to 0, I tell it to write it as a is positive. Now if I want to check whether this positive number is even or odd also, so I put another condition, if a %2 equal to 0. So if the condition is true, it will write as a is even. And if the condition is false, so it will write as a is odd. So this condition, these statements, all these statements will be executed only if a greater than equal to 0 is true. So if it is true, it will write a is positive, and in the positive statement, it will check whether it is even or odd. If the a greater than equal to 0 is not true, it will go to the else statement and it will write the number is negative. Similarly, the lines written in the blue one can also be checked for the negative integers. Again, you can put your if else statement in the negative and it will check whether it is even and odd. So let us compile and run the program. Let us see whether it is working or not. So again, I enter the number. I enter the number as -7. I have taken a negative integer. So I know, everybody know what will be the answer. It will similarly go to the else statement and write the number is negative. You can see it has printed the number is negative. Again, if we put a positive value, let us put a positive value. Let I put a 78. Now you know that 78 is a positive integer and as well as even integer. So when I enter it, what is the result? You can see here the number 78 is positive, and it is also checking that the A is even also. Let us now execute it for an odd integer, odd positive. So let it the number be 37. So when you get, it is writing that A is positive. When it is checking this condition, it is writing it true. So it will write it A is positive. Since it is positive, so again it will check for the percentage to a condition also. And since the percentage condition is not true, it will go to the else and it will say that the number is odd. So it is writing here as A is odd. So in this way, you can use your control statement if else to execute the program or to form the program. Otherwise, you have to write again and again to check it percentage 2 equal to 0, and then again check for even, then again put the condition, then check for odd. And likewise, the steps would be, you would have to write many statements, many steps, and the program would be quite lengthy. So the control statement directs the flow of the program and it makes the program also very simple. Check another program, another control statement, which is the switch statement. So I give you one application of the switch statement. So switch statement is something more related to the if-else statement. So here in the if-else statement, it was checking about the true and the false condition. But in the switch statement, what happens when you have many number of options? So what happens? It could not be covered under the if-else and how many if-else you would be using. So we use these switch statements. So what happens? Suppose we have designed a program used for the switch statement, that we have a report card, and in the report card you have many grades A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. How many grades you want to enter, you can enter it. So now for every grade you want to give a statement line that if he scores an A grade, you should write it as excellent. If it is a B grade, you write it as very good or well done, whatever. So every grade has its own importance and you want to signify in the report card. So we have used the switch statement. So here what is the grade is ABCD. Since it is ABCD, so it is a character, so we have to declare the character. So here in the program we have used char grade, means the grade that we shall be entering will be a character. Then cout, it will enter the grade, it will ask you to enter the grade, and we will enter the grade as A, B, C, D, X, Y, Z, everything. Then switch grade. The condition is the grade that we have written in the bracket, and it will switch, means it will check the grade to which case it will match. So it is case A. The character A, B, C, D are written in the single quotation. So that A, B, C, D will be matched with the condition which is mentioned in the switch. So whichever case will match to the switch condition, it will print the statement which is mentioned for that particular case. So switch case A, printf, excellent. Then break. Break means that it will print the statement for that case and it will execute out of the program. Similarly, we have case B, it will print very good, and then break. If it matches with the case C, it will write well done and it will break. If it is case D, that you have just passed, it will break and get out of the program. If it is F, it will write better try again and break. If it is a default statement, if no ABCD matches with the grade that you have mentioned, it will go to the default statement and it will write out of the switch where there are no statements that you would mention. So it is writing out of the switch or better luck next try. Whatever you want to print in the default, you can write it in the default statement and break. So let us execute the program. So now we are compiling it. So it is asking you to enter the grade. Let us execute the grade as A. So I have entered the grade A, it is writing excellent. So what has it done? It has matched the character grade. Since the grade was a character, it has matched. A grade with the case that were mentioned with the single quotes. Since AA was matched with the case A, it has written excellent. The case here are also the case sensitive, alphabet sensitive. If supposingly you are writing A and you are writing in a small a, and in the case you have mentioned it as a capital A, so it will not match it and it will write it as out of switch, because in the last option, last case, what it was a default. So default is matched with the smaller alphabets, and everything that is not being matched with the cases that you have mentioned will write it as out of switch. So again, if we see, I am writing it as F, capital F. So it matches with the F statement and it writes better try again. Now let us see what happens if you forget to write the break. I am deleting the break from case D and I execute it. I execute it and put D. So what happens? Since for the D, it has matched it with the D case, it is writing you passed. You can see here in the case D, it is writing you passed, but the break is not mentioned here. So it will execute the F case also. It will write better try again. And since in the F case, there was a break, so it will break out and it will go out of the statement. If you forget to write break here also, so what will happen? If you put D, case D, then it would write you pass, better try again and out of the switch. So let us see what happens again. Again, I put D. So you can see it is writing three statements, you passed, better try again and out of the switch. When it will get a break, then only it will stop writing at the output. Otherwise, it will go on writing it. So you want that a particular case is verified, then it should break, it should exit out of the program. Otherwise, there will be error and it will write all the remarks for all the cases. So I hope that you understand what do you mean by the switch statement. So in the control statement, here there was a switch statement. I have already shown you a program of the switch statement. So it is also a conditional statement. So in the switch statement, the syntax is that you have to write the switch expression. In the expression you had regarded as the grade. So the grade would match to the particular cases, case one, case two, case three, and a default case. So for case one, there is a statement one, then there is a break. For case two, there is a statement two, then break. Then if there are no cases matching, there is a default that is writing statement three and break. So the expression in the switch statement that you are writing would be matched with the cases one, two, default, and it would execute according to the matching of these expression, and it would accordingly switch to the particular case it is being matched to. So this is how the switch statement is working, and we shall discuss about the other control statement, that is the for loop statement, while loop, do while loop in the subsequent modules. So I hope to meet you again. Thank you.